Okay. Hi everyone. We are going to the second session of the recruitment process. We talk about that day about the different types of workers in a business organization, right? So we talk about the different four types of workers in an organization. Full-time workers, where they have 48 hours per week working like minimum. Part-time workers who are working less than 30 hours per week. And sometimes job share positions are there. One full-time post they are sharing between two members. Workers, two part-time workers sharing, and other work types of we talk about casual employment and seasonal employment and temporary employment. So today we are going to talk about this process, the recruitment process and the recruitment documents mainly. What are the parts of a job advertisement and mainly the ways of attracting things. So you can see in this short note, so everything is there. Okay, so let's go back to the the textbook. So you can see the recruitment stages. Recruitment process. So everyone knows that thing, guys. Recruitment is very important for any organization, and this is main temporary. The organization is responsibility of the recruitment goes to HR, the HR manager of the organization responsible for the recruitment. So we talk about this. The recruitment will have to do because of several reasons. Because organizations we are recruiting people when the expansion situation, you open up another branch in another city, another country, so this is expanding, we need more labor. It is something we call organic growth, right? We need more labor. And also people are leaving, that means we have to, there's sometimes labor turnover because of sometimes due to retirement, or it can be due to the death of a worker. Sometimes they are, we call labor turnover rate, sometimes they are leaving because sometimes they want to work in somewhere else. So as a result of that, we had to replace this job opportunity, we had to find another person who works in the organization. And because of the promotion, let's say, as I told you, that mainly if an assistant manager promoted as a manager, there's a the vacancy created in the assistant manager post. Like that, when there's a promotion happen, we need to recruit more labor. And then when the people required for a temporary period, such as maternity leave for mothers, paternity leave for fathers, like that, these are the main reasons we need to recruit people. So then therefore you should know what are the recruitment stages of an organization. This should be happen step by step. So because we can't suddenly decide what to recruit, how to recruit, whom to recruit. First of all, you have to decide how much vacancies we have. And thereafter, there are certain stages that are there to follow in the recruitment. You can see this thing actually will process. We can show it from the flow chart first of all. First of all, have kind of identified the type of number of staff needed. How can you do this? As human resource manager in a meeting, you can ask from your heads, right? You can ask from the marketing department head. You can ask, okay, how many people, like, do you have any vacancies right now? Let me know, I can recruit. From production manager, they can ask, okay, manager, let me know how much have your staff requirement, let me know. So we can call application. We can, so the managers say, yeah, in production workers, yes, I have some few line workers, we need to recruit more, right? So I need another, like a five more helpers I need, right? Marketing manager also say, yes, I need some sales executive, like 10 people we have to recruit to do that thing. And we need some delivery, like a driver we need, because we have to, our expansion thing, because of that, we bought a new delivery van, so we need to hire a driver and an assistant like them. So many requirements, they are coming in the organization. We have multiple department, like, you know, marketing, human resource, you know, HR, IT, and operation management, financial management. All these department heads, they are informing the human resource department their staff requirement. So that's the first thing, identify the type and number of staff needed, right? If you have identified properly, how much people, because that's the organization always daily basis, sometimes they have interview process are going on, it's ongoing thing. Right. Sometimes this some interviews normally headed by the department head. Or if it's a managerial position, if it's like a senior level position, sometimes it will be headed by the chairman. Or the other board of directors also coming because the managerial senior level job. But lower level jobs, such as when you're recruiting drivers, executives, and PMs and administration people, so you don't need to go call always chairman. So human resource manager can do it. And he can give job opportunities for them. They can negotiate the terms of salaries and conditions. So the second process is the preparing the job description and person specification an organization. When you're preparing this thing, you have to always follow some procedure. If they are, when you're preparing job description, which describe the job, and person specification, you have to prepare, which give the specification of a person who wanted to looking for a job. For example, like a job description, person specification, I'm doing that in detail now. So what is JD and what is PS? JD or job description is describe the job, like what are the things they are going to do, the roles and responsibilities of that person they are going to, and also the person specification, what are the qualifications we expected from that candidate, what is the experience, number of years we are expecting from that candidate, skills and attitudes of the person we expecting from that candidate, everything we are going to explain in the person specification. These are the main two, you know, parts of a job advertisement, right? And also after preparing the job advertisement, and then you are going to advertise in an appropriate media. It can be a paper article, it can be a online. Nowadays there are so many like websites are there which provide job opportunities. Then you can go and access those websites, and then you can find out the job. Advertising is another, let's say, third stage. After advertising, then people start sending their applications to the organization. This application must be reviewed. So this is reviewed by evaluation applications, evaluative part, and then select a short list for an interview. Because when there is a post like a senior management, sometimes a lot of people might like the 200, 300 applications sometimes can come, collect. But it is not practical and possible, and it's time consuming to interview all of them. Therefore, what you can do, you can minimize, you can take the 10% of it, can reject the 90% application, take the 10% of it. Let's say if it's 200 applications, you can reject 90% and you can keep the only 10%, like 20 applications you can select the best out of best, based on their qualification, experience, skills. Based on that, you can identify the top 20, like a best prospectors, candidates who can go for an interview. And then out of that, you can evaluate the best out of best after the shortlist process. Then you can call them for an interview. And after that, you can carry out the interviews with them like a face-to-face, because 20 number is low, and not 20. Sometimes there can be a couple of rounds of interview, first interview, second interview, and the final interview. Sometimes you might it will be happen with the chairman, and like a last interview always be decided by the chairman and board of directors. It's like a selecting like a superstar, né? Like always the cutoff rounds are there. Then a lot of people rejecting at the end, only like one person or one or two members will be selected. And then evaluate the interviews and appoint the best candidate. That's a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 stage, and the 7th stage, provide feedback for unsuccessful applicants. Like in the interview, let's say they say 20 members, but only one person got selected. You have to inform other 90 members of staff who came that time, candidates. Sorry, you are unable to be normally, like give some kind of response for them, like for we'll keep you informed, right? You are not selected for this post, something like that. Sometimes they're calling and asking, so you have to inform them. So feedback is really important. So I have to politely have to tell that information for them, okay? For the unsuccessful candidates, because they're expecting what's going on, what's happened in that interview, something. Because always in the interview process, they are not telling you they are selected for something. You say, we'll inform you later, something. So then, if person selected, they call you and tell, okay, you are selected, can you come for work from tomorrow? Like that. So you are telling them sometime face to face. So, but most of the time they are for unsuccessful candidate, they are not informing that thing face to face, because sometimes it will be hard for them to communicate. Okay, so let's recruitment. The process is like that. So you can see here, first stage, to identify the number of staff needed. Again, I'm telling. So then first of all, you have to find out that how many people need to attract, how many people need to be called. And then second stage, you can see the right people are more likely to be selected. You have to prepare a job description and person specification must be created. Then advertise the job in the suitable medium. It can be a website, it can be a newspaper, or it can be even notice board if you want to recruit internally. And then you can see, then you can write person, you can see, then sort it. Then we call track sufficient interest from the right sort of applications. And also job seekers are likely to apply for the job community job application form, or send in their curricular vita, we call CV. There are two things are there, guys. So first one is a application form, job application form. You can see job application form is a standard document using the collection information from job application. Sometimes organization giving, okay, just fill this form and come. Like lower level job, sometimes like a skill jobs they are given this application form. They don't need to fill a CV because CV or curriculum vitae biodata sometimes they are expecting from the senior level people, but for the some lower level jobs then they can actually ask the to fill the some application form to fill from labor jobs. They can do this thing to just basic information, their name, address, telephone number, bank account, everything. And then job seekers like to apply for a job, complete a job application form or CV, then you can this application you can review and then you can make a short list. Then shortlisted applications, then you can invite it for an interview, as I told you, 10-20 maximum. After the interview, you can select the best candidate appointment and then giving feedback for unsuccessful candidates, the last topic. So this everything actually in my the short note, you can see the in this handout, you can see everything summarized like this. So you can see the business, why they need to recruit, for four reasons, and the recruitment stages. Why you should know this stage? Because it's there in some past papers. If you analyze like a couple of past papers, these stages being asked. Sometimes they are giving is the levels, they get numbers and they have to find out A, B, C, D, like that. You have to prepare the correct order. They are giving a list and you have to find out the list out of them. A, B, C, D, E, F, like that. So this order must be, you should know, you should study this order properly. Identify the vacancy, prepare the JDPS, advertise it, shortlisting, interview them, appoint the best one, giving feedback for unsuccessful candidate. So as I told you, when you're preparing this job advertisement, this can you can attract application from various way. Example, advertising is the first thing, like you can do the paid method. You have to pay money for the newspapers and the websites to advertise your job. Other one is a job center. You can, there are some government funded organizations out there, job centers, some job banks. You can tell them that you are as an employer, you can register there and you can send you all the vacancies, you can inform to job centers. Then the unemployed people can register in the job centers. Then there's a vacancy comes, those job center informing them, okay, here there's a vacancy there, like you are looking for. Imagine you are a banker, unemployed banker, and so vacancy coming from a bank, then they can contact the relevant person and tell, okay, here a banking vacancy is there, so you can go and talk to them. You can go for an interview like that. Direct applications also there, sometimes without a vacancy advertisement, sometimes directly unemployed people, they try to apply. Some organization, they are finding the email address and they're sending their just email. So they're posting the letters, their CVs and everything. They're asking, okay, I'm a candidate like this. I'm a qualification, everything. I'm looking for a job these days. If you have a suitable vacancy, please call me, like that. So direct applications are there. But if organization should be established organization, we not recruit like that. That means without any vacancy, people are asking me, this would be a good company, must have a very good reputation, right? And word of mouth is another thing. This is famous for internal recruitment method. You can tell your workers, your co-workers, okay, there's a vacancy like that. If you know someone, please bring. There's opportunities there. For example, if you need another driver, if you need to employ another, let's say, shop assistant, or machine operator. So you can, without advertising, you can tell the existing staff members, okay, there's a vacancy here. If you know your friend, please let him know that there's a vacancy. Please bring him, like that. Word of mouth also is another way of attracting. And another thing is private employment agencies are there, like we call manpower companies are there. So then they're working for different employers, like sometimes government agencies, like airports, harbor, like strategic locations. These workers, daily basis, they hire people, so you have to work in them in the employment agency. The employment agencies get the salaries and they are keeping some percentage, like let's say 25%, they are giving 75% to the worker, right? Imagine your salary is, let's say, 1 lakh, so they are giving 25,000, they are keeping, and 75,000 they are giving for you. It's a manpower company, so you're working for them, and these people find jobs and they hire you, and it's like a labor company, so labor supplier. So there is no, it's like a third party company, so you can work with a third party company, but the fringe benefits, nothing is coming for the workers who are working employment agencies, because those are manpower companies only. Like you can see this kind of thing, like cleaning, outsourcing companies, cleaning, security. So employment agencies who provide, if you want to, no need to take some kind of like a permanent position, we can call casual workers from employment agencies. And sixth method is a headhunting method, right? Don't scare, like not Headhunting means like attracting staff from, it's a very good business term, from rival companies offering higher wages. Like this is best employees in other organization always being, they are giving some attention and they are giving calling them from other rival companies, okay, but you must be famous for it. For example, you say, if I produce good results sometimes, so other organization might call me and then they are, sometimes they might ask you, okay, I will give you more salary. Would you like to join with us, right? Like this happen normally organizations in hotels, hotel sectors, in airlines, in the every industry, pharmaceutical industries, and then marketing divisions. Because imagine if you are a very good marketeer, right? You are selling the progress, your records, you are the highest, the person who brings more sales always. You are very well reputed, you have a good reputation in the industry also for the doing good business for their organization. Then what happened? The other finance companies, leasing companies, in the marketing department, they might call you and ask, okay, why don't you join with us? We'll pay you more. Can you take our branch? Can you run, can take the leadership of our branch, like that? Sometimes with the promotion, with more packages they're offering with you, that's called headhunting. But it should be a very good organization, the position, not to be headhunted. Otherwise, if you are not suitable enough for them, they will not call you, right? So I told you there are two things are there in job advertisement, JD, job description, which describe the job, right? There are tasks, duties, and responsibilities expected. The worker, particular details of the job is mean there in the job description. The second part in the second paragraph of the job advertisement is a PS or person specification, the person profile of the worker. So you can see these things in this job advertisement. You can see this JD and PSI shortened form. JD, you can say TDR. Tasks, duties, and responsibilities. Easily memorized. So this time, try to memorize this thing. TDR, right? And other one is a person specification. We call it QESA. Q-E-S-A. Q-E-S-A. Qualifications, experience, skills, and attitudes. So you know these are the two parts of a job. TD, job description, TDR, person specification, QESA. Q-E-S-A. Qualification, experience, skills, attitudes, right? So these are the main thing, right? And then, so I want you to, I'll show you mainly what are this process, these stages sometimes very important, and this even this handout also you can see the stages of the recruitment process, everything mentioned here, recruitment, recruiting staff, and then the vacancy coming here, job advertisement, and then person specification, qualification, experience, skills, everything, and then, this is the vacancy for a graphic designer, inter recruitment, and then you can see interview, and then giving the job opportunities. Right. So now this recruitment process is here. Recruitment process. We'll go through what is job description and person specification. So now I'll show you how to actually these things actually been publicized. You can see if you go to this website called say Top Jobs, right? This is a Sri Lankan website who actually published all the jobs in right now in Sri Lanka. So there are certain categories out there, like if you're looking for a banking jobs, banking, sales, marketing, hospitality, ticketing, fashion designing, security, agriculture, law. So many sectors are there, right? Let's say go to preferred area. Let's say you're an accountant. Let's say you want to go to accounting job, go to that. And you can see the current job opportunities available. You can see here. So you can see there's a recovery officer jobs are there, recovery officer institution also there. And financial controller for Maldives. There are job opportunities are there. Maldives country and internal auditor for audit company. In finance and interim administration executive like that. Okay, let's go to this accountant or credit controller. This or recovery office job, just prefer the advertisement. I'll share the stream with you right now. This is an example of a job advertisement, guys. So you can see this screen, the recovery officer. So this case, immediate vacancy. And this is called the company description. There is a Java Institute of Advanced Technology. It's a leading research-based higher education institution in Sri Lanka. I think this is something like IT something, some organization. It's ISO 9001:15 certified institution. And so this is called the company description. So this is the most important thing, as I mentioned, recovery, this is a job advertisement, the name of the position, recovery officer. And you can see the here, you can see the description, this is called job description, the part that this describe job. If you become the recovery officer, you have to do these tasks, duties and responsibilities. You can see coordinate with the student to follow up on outstanding payments. Sometimes there might be, because of COVID-19, there might be some payments outstanding. So you have to remind them, right, this coordinate them, some calling them, and so recovery related matters, you have to dealing with them. And plan and coordinate routine recovery process. Planning and coordinating routine recovery process. And daily collection reporting to the department head. So you have to report to the head of the department about their collection process and procedure. And finally, plan and achieve monthly collection targets. You have to plan it first of all, and to achieve that aim at the end of the month, the collection target must be achieved. That's why if you have a, this is another, the recovery, this organization, in every organization right now, you know, even banks, they have a jobs like that, finance company, leasing companies, they have a job like this, right? This is a finance related thing, this is not accounting job, this is a like a recovery section, like a loan recovery something job. So this is a task, duties and responsibilities. You had to report to someone and do this thing. So what kind of a QESA, qualification, experience, skills, attitudes were expected from this candidate? So look at the requirement section, you can see good communication skills in English and single languages, right? Good communication skills is a skill, and should be energetic and must have can do attitude. Yes, I can. Like that attitude must be there. That is what attitudes section, right? And experience section, look at this, minimum 1 year of working experience is a similar position. At least 1 year experience as a recovery officer is enough. And computer literacy, another thing, because I think you have to work with the computers, right? There's details, data entry, and then making the Word, like at least Word, Excel, PowerPoint, something. And preferred age should be 25 to 40 years. Qualification, experience, skills, and these are the main things. So like, suitable candidate, if you are within the age of 25 to 40, and with the one year experience we worked before, and if you have these qualification skills, you can apply. You can apply, and then they send your CV to the following email. So this is the good, like a typical example of a job advertisement. So you can find out mainly in this advertisement, there are two sections are there, right? Two sections mainly, JD, job description, and person specification, like that. So every organization, they have put in there this kind of advertisements when you want to recruit someone, the selected the candidate they want to control. For example, let's say this one, financial controller, they expect you from another country. Say look at this job opportunity. So I'll take you to that advertisement as well, so you can find another JD and PS there. So job description here, you can see another, the financial controller organization, some Maritime International Limited. Financial controller, you can see there are a lot of duties, my God. No? So you can see TDR, ne? Task, duties, responsibilities are, they number it also, ne? 1, 2, 3, 4, how many? So I'm not going to read everything, guys. So there are, the list continues like 36 responsibilities they follow. This is the thing in detail you can give. If they are going to publish this in a newspaper, they have to pay a huge amount of money. But here, because it's online, since online, so you can, this financial controller is like a CFO, we call CFO, Chief Financial Officer. Something like this can be a head position in an organization, in a finance department, must be run by him. So 36 functions. We'll read a few things. Under the general supervision of board of directors, so they had to report board of directors, right? And so, within the company limits and policies, procedures, local requirement, responsible for supervision of all members of finance and stores department. So it is a head position. There are a lot of people working under you, some other finance, accounts clerks and store people. And also provide financial guidance to executive and committee department heads. departmental heads. Not only that, some tax consultation matters, auditing matters, and so and so, so and so, so and so. You can see risk continues. Tasks, duties, responsibilities, they're nicely given in this example. This is a typical example of a good job advertisement. This is called job advertisement. I think you can easily understand what the job advertisement mean. Okay, let's go to the other thing. Required candidate profile and qualification. Okay, look at this. A fully or semi-qualified chartered accountant. Qualification. Fully qualified or semi-qualified. Partly qualified also okay. But look at experience. 7+ post CA experience. After qualified, you have to work at least 7 years experience. Because to be a CFO, to be a head of a department, to work with like a lot of people to control, you have to be mature. Like you must have at least 7 year qualification actually. It's possible because you must have a maturity. No? Otherwise, how can you control people? How can you do all these 36 functions? Ne? So many things are there. Supervising account staff and maintaining orderly accounting, filing system, everything. So you have to have a well-experienced guy they expected for this job. And also must have experience in the project management and also experience in oil and gas field with added qualification. Because why is I think some logistics section, some oil and gas, some thing. And also candidate must be in his mid-40s, expecting a person like a mid-40s, because otherwise it's difficult to find a person with like a 7+ year experience. They expecting a person mid-40s, like around 40, 45, 46, like that. And not more than 47 years of age. This is the age restrictions. But guys, in legislation part, you're talking about this thing separate, like in some, you know, UK, they normally, this is kind of a age limits must not be, this is a new thing must be, I think age limits not better to not to disclose, because this is a violation of kind of a, like a Age Discrimination Act is there, 1993 age discrimination, because anyone must be able to apply, like, but because they have a shortlisting process, I think they are giving it because then easy for them to shortlist. That's why 40 to 47, they are giving the age limit for this. And also, look at the QESA, qualification, skills, and attitude section. They need for this position, a person with the bachelor's degrees or master's degrees in accounting, business, economics, finance, or a related field in addition to the CA qualification. So that professional qualification plus an academic qualification also, they require some bachelor's degree or a master's degree, MBA degree. I think these are a lot of people are doing the master's courses and everything along with the professional courses like CA stands for Chartered Accounting courses qualification, and also several years of experience in the business or finance environment, project management experience, leadership skills, interpersonal skills, outstanding mathematical skills. Because why? To be an accountant, you must have mathematical knowledge. You are working with numbers, ne? And other attitudes. Honesty, integrity, reliability, what else? Solid written and verbal communication skills. One of the best, I think, advertisement I recommend for you to read. This is very good advertisement because everything is there clearly. Qualification, experience, skills, attitudes, and 36 functions of the task duties and responsibilities, job description. Big advertisement. And also, the person's qualities must, there must be honest. One, number one, honest. To be accountant, because why you're working with numbers, with the money, integrity, reliability, and also high attention to detail, organization skills, critical thinking, problem solving skills, other skills they need, research skills, analytical skills, computer skill. What else? Understanding of data privacy standards, and also must be able to advise the board of directors in financial investment. Must be a good, you know, like a consultant also in case of a, like investment thing, must be able to give your viewpoint to the investors as well. It's not like a just a sitting and working, it's actually a proactive opportunity. A person must have financial control, means must be able to govern all the financial department works related stuff, must be a good advisor, must give you support and value addition to the company board of directors. So your monthly salary is $2,500 per month. Salary they reveal package, 60% of the salary will be paid till March 2021 because of the COVID thing. And I think until March, they're giving only 60%. and full salary from April 2021. Guys, 2,500 US dollars is like a quite a good salary. This is basic like a salary in the normally above the minimum wage rates in some countries, right? Let's say 2,500 rupees. If you convert into Sri Lankan rupees, now dollar rate goes like 193. This is they are giving monthly salary 482,000. It's around 500,000, like a half a million salary, 5 lakh salary, around that salary, and free accommodation. This other remuneration thing, other benefits that additionally called perks, because you are working foreign country, right? Accommodation, food and food allowance, special medical insurance, and per company policy. So free joining and leave air tickets, right? Because it's a organization in Maldives, so you have to air tickets, everything provided, like a 500,000 you can earn a month. So that's how it works. It's a job description. I think you have a very good idea about the most important thing, how your job description, how person specification, everything working. So let's move on to the other. After doing job description, after you having this job description and person specification, then you have to interview people, you have to advertise this thing, and then you have to find out then how to appoint the best people. So job description, person specification, now we discussed that part, you have a very good understanding. You know how what are the parts of a job advertisement. Okay, so next part is, you can see this is a given example also, typical example. I think better than this, I think you just saw a very good advertisement. So here accounts clerk, the title and general code role is there, the job description part, role, responsibilities, salary, né? And hours and conditions of the work, that everything given job description. So other one is a QESA, the qualification, experience, skills, attitudes, essential, desirable, right? These kind of things are there, qualification, education, experience, communication skill, other skills, personal attributes, then self-motivated, honesty, integrity, my God, so many things are there, right? So these are the main two documents, guys, we talk about. Like mainly after this doing that thing, so there's another document called application form. So candidates are normally supposed to apply for a job opportunity, job organization. Some organization, they already publish the application form as well. So application form is general standard, like a standard form. They have like some Google forms we have right now. So you have to mention these things. It's easy for them to organization, then analyze and shortlist your full name and address, personal or tax identification number, and details of the education, your employment history, like online, sometimes you can fill this application from right now. Then you don't need to send a personalized email, because then if you take 10 applications, then 10 different formats, right? But if you have one format, one application format, this is provided by the employer. So don't forget about that thing. This application form provided by the employer at the beginning. Sometimes if you want to join, you can download the application form from their website, and then you can apply, and then that one you can email to the company. They sometimes specifically mention, please download the application from our website, and then you sell that, fill it and send it. Oh, then they don't need any CV, personal CV from you, because this is relevant information they can easily collect, and they can compare after that, easy for them to comparison purpose. That's why they are making some organization, they have application forms. Some other information of that, sometimes they ask me your hobbies, address of the two referees. Who are the referees? Sometimes asking non-related referees, some people who can recommend about you, right? So we can recommend about you. For example, it can be a teacher, it can be a principal, it can be someone like a person who known, like not a family member, some outsider who a recognized person in society. It can be a religious leader, it can be a manager of a company, it can be a lawyer, someone, it can be another like a respectable person in the society like that. So you have to give someone name and address too. Sometimes companies asking, they're calling and asking, okay, do you know, for example, this, Mr. X, he actually sent us a CV, do you know about him? Can you recommend him? Sometimes these referees might be good, give you a very good recommendation about you. And declaration of the health issues, right, might impede the fulfillment of an application duties. Like sometimes they're asking, sometimes organization, some jobs they're asking medical reports also. Because some jobs you need to have that special, like a pilot job, you have vision, everything, like especially some jobs like forces, sometimes they are asking them to do the medical checkups, medical tests and everything. They are normal, they are checking in the beginning of the enrollment. So these are the main thing. So it is also common for a business to ask application for support the application from the cover letter, perhaps writing them to add any further information they think might be relevant for their application. And also the last one, guys, we're talking about CV, right? CV thing, actually I'm going to do it in detail in another session, right? Curriculum vita. Normally you have to prepare your own CV because sometimes called biodata, standard document. Sometimes you can contain your information with the photo, nice photo taken recently, and everything, personal information, education qualification, professional qualification, extracurricular activities like that, and your personal statement, everything. So it's like a small 2-page, 3-page document about yourself. You introduce yourself, you market yourself, and this is about you introduce yourself. It's called a CV. So, and when you interested for that job, you are expecting and you are sending that CV for an organization. Then by analyzing them, they call you and they select you for an interview after shortlisting. So this is another way to assess the application. Sometime in the interview also, you can ask some question face to face, then only you can assess the applicant's presentation skills and quality of their work. Okay, before we wrap up the lesson, I'll summarize the things that we have discussed today. We talk about the stages of recruitment, right? On the stage of recruitment, we talk about mainly we should have the stages, select the number of candidates you need, vacancies first of all identify, then you have to prepare the each and every job. We have to prepare JD and PS, job descriptions, personal specification, then advertise those in a website or newspaper, and then people then sending applications, CVs, shortlist them, and then you have to call in them for an interview and carry out the interviews, select the best candidate, appointment, and then finally give the feedback on successful candidate. And after that, we talk about the main two documents, JD and PS, job description, which describe the job, task duties, responsibilities, person specification, which specify the person's qualification, experience, skills, and attitude. We cover QESA, TDR and QESA, right? Don't forget these mnemonic codes. Like every session, I'm giving this kind of mnemonic code for you to easy to memorize these things. And we talk about, we went to a sample example of a applications, job notices, job vacancy advertisement. I show you two vacancy advertisements right now. And I told you there are two methods that candidates can apply, either by completing an application form given by the organization, or either you can make your own CV or curriculum vita or CV or resume, and then you can send that document to the organization prepared by you. Okay, these are the methods that we discussed today. Then that's all our session today. Then see you again on next session. Thank you very much. Bye.
Awesome. Thank you,
sir.
Thank you.